Hello guys, this is Bhavna Jaiswal and I am going to tell you about the sterilization technique. So first of all, what is sterilization? This is the method to kill or to remove the microbes from the surrounding or from our desired substance. So before starting, we must know that why this is important and why we are doing this. So this is important in industries, food packaging and labs etc. where the contamination occur and we need to clean it. So to inhibit the growth of microbes, we can do two things. First is decontamination and second is disinfection. In decontamination, we treat the object which we want to clean, not the microbes. And in disinfection, we directly target the microbes, not the object. So for these, for the sterilization, we have two methods, physical and chemical method. So we will start with the physical method. In this, temperature, radiation and filtration method is used. So in temperature, there is two temperature method, like high temperature can be used and low temperature. Low temperature, we experience it at our home, that we keep the food items in the fridge to prevent the microbial growth. And in labs and etc., there is minus 20 and minus 80 degree centigrade temperature is used to prevent the contamination. In high temperature, we have many methods. So before starting the temperature heat, we have a few terminologies, like temperature optima, that is every microorganism have an optimum temperature on which the microbe survive. And beyond that temperature, the macromolecules of the microbes get starting denaturation. And we have thermal death point, thermal death time. This is the minimum time required to kill the microbe. And one is the decimal reduction time. Decimal reduction time is the time required for a tenfold reduction in the microbial viability. So with these, we will start the heat. In this heat, we have dry heat and moist heat methods. In dry heat, we have direct flaming, incineration and oven sterilization. Direct flaming and incineration is to directly treat the object on the flame. So oven sterilization method is used for glassware, where it is kept in oven for at 60 to 70 degrees for 2 to 3 hours. And in moist heat, we have boiling. We also do this at our home and in hospitals to sterilize the syringe or other things. Autoclaving. In this method, steam is generated under high pressure and the pressure is of 15 psi and the temperature reached to 121 degree centigrade. So at this temperature, even the endospores of bacteria can't survive. And we have one more technique related to similar to autoclaving, is strindalization. In this, steam is generated but not under pressure. Steam for 30 to 45 minutes is given for 3 days, this will destroy the vegetative cells. And if the overnight spores are present, overnight they will get germinated, then again for the second day the steam will destroy. Next is pasteurization. This is done for milk or other beverages. In this, the milk or beverages are heated at 71 degree centigrade for 15 seconds, and then rapid cooling is done. And one more is there, ultra high temperature. This is done for producing self milk that does not require freezing. The milk is heated 140 to 150 degree centigrade for 1 to 3 seconds, and then rapid cooling is done. Now we are coming to the radiation method. In this radiation method, two radiations are used, that is UV radiation, that is a non-ionizing radiation, and ionizing radiation. UV radiation of 220 to 300 nanometer is used. DNA molecules of the microbes or other DNA molecules absorb the UV radiation at 260 nanometer. So this fall in the UV range. So DNA molecule, after absorbing the UV radiation, get denaturated. And ionizing radiation, the UV radiation is used in laminar flow. In ionizing radiation, ionizing radiation generate electrons, reactive molecular species, hydroxyl radicals and hydride radicals that react with the macromolecules and denature them, and so the killing of the microbes occur. Ionizing radiation basically that is used is gamma rays. And the source of this is cobalt-60. And now coming to the filtration method. Filtration method is used for the heat labile substance, means that the substance that cannot be heated. So we have in this again two kinds of filtration: depth filter and membrane filter. In depth filter, that is made up of borosilicate or diatomaceous earth, the substance is arranged irregularly and the particles get trapped inside. The particles get trapped inside the filter, and so this is called depth filter. And in membrane filter, the particles get trapped on the surface, and so this is called the membrane filter. This membrane filter is acting more like a sieve, and a particular pore sizes can be obtained. And this is made up of cellulose, acetate or nitrate. And this is all about the physical method of sterilization. Now coming to the chemical method. In chemical method, we have few terminologies before starting, like bactericidal or bacteriostatic, fungicidal or fungistatic. Bactericidal and fungicidal. So cidal means is to kill the microbes, and static means is to inhibit the growth of that microbes. Means if there is any fungistatic, it will only inhibit the growth of the microbe, not will kill the but not kill the microbes. And one more is that MIC. This is minimum inhibitory concentration. That is the minimum amount of a minimum amount of the reagent or agent that is required to kill the particular microbe. This is MIC. And we have some examples of chemical sterilant is alcohol. This act as a lipid solvent and protein denaturant. Means the cell wall of the microbes are made up of lipid bilayer. So this alcohol will solubilize this lipid molecules, and so the cell wall get disrupted and the microbes get killed. And we have some phenol containing compound like triclosan and chlorhexidine. They also disrupt the cytoplasmic membrane. Some heavy metals like silver, mercury, copper, zinc, etc. They react with the thiol or amine group of the protein or enzyme and denature them. Some halogens like chlorine and iodine. They also react with the amino acid and change the structure of the protein. Various gases like chlorine dioxide, ethylene oxide and vapor phase H2O2 etc. act as oxidizing agent. And copper sulfate act as protein precipitant, means that it will precipitate the protein of the cell. So this is about the chemical sterilizing agents. And now we are coming to the biological. Biological is more or less related to the human body, means the sterilizing agent that are used in that means the biological agents means that can be used for human body, means to remove the microbes or to kill the microbes inside the human body in vivo. So we have two kinds of things, like synthetic drugs and antibiotics. In synthetic drugs, these basically act as analogs of some compound that is used in the biochemical pathways of the cell. So, like synthetic drugs, we have sulfur drugs and quinolones. Like sulfur drugs, sulfanilamide is then analog of para-aminobenzoic acid. This is a part of a folic acid, vitamin folic acid, and that is the precursor of nucleic acid. So sulfanilamide get incorporated in place of para-aminobenzoic acid and inhibit the synthesis of nucleic acid. Same is the with quinolones. This inhibit the interfere with the DNA gyrase of bacterial cell and thus interrupt the supercoiling of the DNA. And antibiotics, as we all know, that is the source of the antibiotics is itself the microbes, and it works against the microbes. So like for example, we have Streptomyces bacteria that produces a lot of antibiotics. Different species of Streptomyces produce different antibiotics like streptomycin, rifampin, kanamycin, amphotericin, tetracycline and fluoromphenicol. And we have bacillus bacteria, like bacteria bacillus produces polymyxin. Various fungi like penicillium produces the penicillin wonder drug. Cephalosporium produces cephalosporin, etc. The antibiotics either inhibit the synthesis of a particular compound or the function of a compound. So like penicillin, this inhibits the cell wall synthesis. Protein synthesis is inhibited by kanamycin and streptomycin. Nucleic acid synthesis, like we have DNA and RNA, so replication is inhibited by ciprofloxacin, and RNA synthesis is inhibited by rifampin. Likewise, cell membrane disruption occur by polymyxin, and metabolic pathways are disrupted by the taxon and their function. So these are the few antibiotics and their functions. So this is all about the sterilization methods. So by using these different kind of things, we can sterilize our desired media, or the surrounding, like laminar flow where we can work, our molecular room, culture room, etc. And if you have any question, any doubts, please leave your comment. We are here to help you. Thank you.